It is Friday, June 3rd, 2023, and I am all packed up for my first trip to New Ulm, Minnesota, where I will be attending Martin Luther College, the Wells College of Ministry. I was quite surprised how much stuff I was able to fit in this little U-Haul here. It's a 5x8, got a lot more in there than I was expecting. And the big load in the back of the truck. It's a 13 and a half hour drive ahead of me. I'll be picking my dad up before I head out. And we will be stopping in Escanaba at a friend's house tonight and continuing on into Minnesota Sunday. It is Sunday, June 4th, 2023, and I'm in the new house in New Ulm, Minnesota. My dad is here with me, and we're going to get our trailer unloaded, and 2 or 3 weeks, mosey on back to Michigan to pick up the rest of the stuff.
It's Wednesday, June 6th, 2023. My father and I arrived in New Ulm, Minnesota safely on Sunday. Got our U-Haul trailer dropped back off on Monday and have just kind of been unpacking and trying to get things squared away a little bit. Been feeling quite desolate and, I don't know, out of touch and depressed and scared today. It's a lot, you know. Walking away from everything you know, everything that you have worked your life to have, being the sole provider for your family and walking away from your job and not being able to have a paycheck to take care of your family, not having insurance for your family. It's taxing. It's taxing. I got a job interview, a couple of job interviews lined up here. I applied for a whole slew of jobs today. I'm hoping something pans out here soon. I really need to find some kind of a part-time job here. I think that would help my disposition greatly. It's overwhelming. It's a lot of weight there. Miss my family. They're 15 and I don't know, half hours away. My wife, my 5-year-old son, and my 10-month-old daughter. The rear end in my truck is not holding up super well. I think I need to replace my pinion bearings and just kind of rebuild that. I don't know about the pinion gear or the ring gear. I don't have time to take it apart or to just take it apart and work on it right now. It got us here towing the trailer, but it still needs to get us back to Michigan, my dad and I. I pray God that he will bless us and that the truck will at least get us back to Michigan. And then I'm going to spend most of a couple weeks trying to figure out what I need to do to get that fixed. I can't bring the truck back here with it the way it is. I still have stuff that I need to transfer to bring over here to another trailer, and I don't trust it to make it again. I just don't. So it's been overwhelming. I'm just very overwhelmed right now. I keep reassuring myself that, you know, the Lord is there. This is where he's guided me. This is what he's asked me to do. But it's not easy. You know, if you're watching this, you're probably, you know, looking at doing what I'm doing, or you're in the middle of doing what I'm doing, you know, becoming a second career pastor. And you've dropped everything you've ever known, and you've come to an unfamiliar town to go to school. You have no idea how you're going to pay rent, buy food, take care of your family, pay tuition. It's a complete leap of faith. It's a tough one. And I don't know, it's just tough. I keep asking myself, why me? Why after all these years? Have I been called into this? Knowing that I could have done this at any time in the past when I was younger. One of the other many times that I was called into this and I just ignored it. Made up excuses. And I'm 43 years old, it's a lot to just drop your entire career. You know, I worked in IT for 12 and a half years. I made enough money to take care of my family. You know, we didn't have money by any means, but I knew I had a paycheck from week to week. I really do not feel like I deserve this honor. But I'm here. This is, I'm sure, the same reason why you're here. Strength is something that we can only draw from the Lord. There's nowhere other way to get it. We are not the commanders of our own lives. We are the humble servants of our Lord and Savior. And we have been called to lead his children. If that's heavy enough as is. But being asked to drop everything and follow him, to go where he leads you and not have a clue where that is. Ultimately, all we have is our faith that he will provide, because he always has, and that it will be all right, and the things that we need will come to us, and he will give these things to us, and that will be the reward for our faith, that we will be allowed to pursue this great honor. To be a pastor or a priest or whatever your denomination has. You know, we're not the first. You're not the first. I'm certainly not the first to be called into the service of the Lord to fight with this. I mean, the disciples, they just, you know, dropped everything and went. And constantly throughout the Bible, all you see is the history of faith in God and in the Lord. I mean, when the Israelites were faithful, God blessed them with plenty. When they were unfaithful, God took that away and delivered them into the hands of their enemies. Jonah ran long and hard, trying to get away from God. And I know from personal experience, it's not something you can do. You certainly can't run from the Lord. You can't run from the calling. When he wants you to do something, you just do it. You say, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you will take care of my family and I. I believe that you will provide what we need to get through this." You just gotta remember those who've come before you, those who have given everything up to follow the Lord to do as he asks, as they are told, and to know that ultimately it is really all you can do with your life. I know that this is all that I've ever truly wanted to do with mine. It's not easy. You're certainly, you're not alone. You just need to pray and you need to have faith. No matter how overwhelming it seems. Because a lot of people have come before us, come before me, come before you, and have suffered a lot more. Have certainly carried bigger crosses than I have. I know that for certain, but I'm just a man, a weak man, and I am nothing without our Lord, without his love, without his strength. And that is the only way that I will get through this. That's all I've ever had is my faith. It's what has kept me alive in my life, and it is what will deliver me through this process, get me through the 2 years here in New Ulm, get me through seminary and my vicar year, and wherever the Lord sends me in my family.